Olga, hello, how are you? Well, we have talked about it several times, and I'm sure if we come across an idea from a book, maybe, or a film, or a story that's interesting, we would probably do it. But as of now, we haven't yet found the story. But I do find it, as a lyricist, interesting to have something to grab hold of. So if you have a story that you can run, that can run through the whole album, it's easier as a lyricist because you have a focus all the time. But it needs to be good and make sense. There's been a few good ones, but we'll see. We're basically a rock band, you know. We'll see. We'll see what happens. Hello, Vonnie. That's kind of a difficult question because some songs just take 3 days to do. You know, you do a demo or you meet the guys in rehearsal and it goes really fast. Some songs take like 20, 25 years because you bring it up in rehearsal with the band every 5 years or so when you make an album, or every 3 years. Bring It All Home, for instance, on Bag of Bones, the ballad. It was called Mystified. It's from a jam in San Francisco. Me and Mick were a bit hungover, and we jammed when we were writing for Prisoners in Paradise. We lived at top of Lombard Street, that street that goes like that, and the whole band in the house. And we came up with that idea back then, and we've tried several times over the years to finish it. But it was Ian, the drummer, who really pushed us on when we were recording Bag of Bones. Try that idea, move it forward. And the same thing with New Love in Town on Last of Good Eden. That was also from that jam session in San Francisco in 1990 or something. So some songs can take 25 years, some songs, you know, 3 days. In the end, none is more difficult or easier than the other, I think. You just got to get right. You have to get your song and the lyrics and the groove up there with the best that's out there. So you need to compare yourself with the best and put it up there and just work on it, you know? Well, in 86, we were sort of joining this wild circus. Everybody wanted a piece of Europe. We know what it feels like to be one of the biggest bands on the planet. We know what it feels like to go on 3 or 4 months of promotion tours with only interviews and playback shows that a few of the guys in the band got really tired of. The musician in us got really tired of all these interviews and playback shows when you don't actually play live. The difference today is that we tell our record company and people that we don't do playback show. We want to play live. So you better bring some amps in there, and we come to your TV show, but we play live. So what I'm trying to say is that we got more control and we do exactly what we feel like doing, and it seems to be working. You got experience and you still got 5 guys that will do everything for the band. We're lucky. But we are planning things a bit better. We don't go on tour for a year and, you know, without going home. We plan breaks every now and then when we tour, and we have control, take control of our business and own our music. And yeah, it's a bit different now. But the great thing is that it's 5 guys that know each other, and we've known each other since we were teenagers. And we work with friends, and we tour, and we meet fans and friends all over the world. We have a great job. Yeah, Anita, hello. Actually, the last year or so, we have started talking more and more serious about it, because we get requests all the time to do maybe there's a director or a script writer or a TV show, or a lot of authors want to co-write a book with us and stuff, because maybe it's time soon, you know. We met when we did live at Sweden Rock. Patrik Ullaus filmed this show, and he's done 4 videos with us as well. Last of Good Eden, New Love in Town, and then Firebox, and Not Supposed to Sing the Blues. And we were filming this interview sequence on the DVD, Live at Sweden Rock. There's an interview sequence where we sit and talk. We just started talking about old memories, and he just said, stop, you can't do this now, we'll do it separately. Because we started going in when we met, and how we go to parties together, and how we wrote songs, and all that stuff that was from the very beginning came out when the camera was rolling. He has some of it already, but then we thought, okay, let's do this soon. So yes, we want to do either a TV or a film, TV documentary or film or something, whatever people's interested in, about how it felt coming from Stockholm and breaking the rest of the world and becoming a touring rock band and and having a great time, you know, over the years. And there's been some ups and downs, so we would obviously talk about that too. So a short answer to your question is yes, we're beginning to think about it. And, you know, hopefully it'll be soon. Oh, there are two different things. Spare time at home in London, I would spend time with my son and my wife. But he's my son is like he's 6 years old now, and we build a lot of stuff together. So that's really cool. After a show, we try to have these rock clubs in our dressing room. We're quite pathetic, you know. We only have a few lights, and somebody has a small ghetto blaster or a system, and we play our favorite songs. You know, here on Planet Rock, I'm going to do this New Year's Eve show with Paul Anthony, and I pick my favorite songs. And those, some of those songs we play after each show, because first we wind down. We have maybe a beer or two and talk about the gig. And then slowly after, maybe, we close the doors, by the way, so no one can get in our dressing room for 45 minutes. It used to be 1 hour, and then it was sort of, it crept down to 45. But no one can get in there. And that's when we just wind down and have a couple of beers and talk about the show. But after that, we slowly come alive. And then we want to hear some of our favorite tracks, you know. And we wind down with music, you know. It could be anything, you know, classic rock, or it could be new rock bands like Rival Sons or anything. Yeah, that's about it. That's all I do. I don't know. I started quite early. I met John Oram when I was 15. He was 14. Before that, I've done a bit of sports, done a bit of ice hockey in Sweden, football in the summers. I was also a go-kart driver for a while. My dad was a mechanic, and we actually competed. I was doing pretty well. But there was a moment there when I was probably 14, 15, when I seriously started listening to rock bands and bump into John Oram and saw his band play. Everything changed. So to answer your question, though, maybe I would be driving a car of some kind, you know, because my dad was really into motorsports, and he put that interest in me and my brother. My brother was a motocross driver for a while. Yeah, maybe I would be doing some motorsports. I don't know. It's so hard to tell, because even when I was 6 or 7, I loved watching music on TV and listening to the radio, David Bowie on the radio, Elton John on the radio. It's always been there, so I can't see myself doing anything else. And when I heard, you know, Deep Purple, Made in Japan, and albums like that, it was no point of no return. It was just, this is what I want to do. I want to tour like these guys, you know? Yeah, right. I think my mom tried to keep me and my brother off the streets and not hanging on street corners. So I did enroll in some sort of gymnastic thing when I was a kid. It wasn't serious at all, but I suppose I did it for a little while. This was all pre-rock and roll. Oh, my real name in Sweden, it's Joakim. So my close family will say that, and my relatives, because they obviously knew me since I was, you know, a tiny lad. So they used to Joakim, or a nickname, which is Jukke. So that's, and some of my old friends as well, school friends, will call me that. But since I moved out of Sweden, and since I started Europe, Joey has just been a natural thing. So friends, business, you know, media, interviews, anybody in London where I live, it'll be Joey, you know, Joey Larson sometimes, or just Joe. Some people call me Joe as well. It was when I went to America. I was only 12 or 13 with my parents, went to Los Angeles. There was people there having a little bit of difficulty with Joakim, and so they just called me Joe. And that, therefore, I came up with Joey. And then I saw this book by Shakespeare with Tempest when I was sneaking down the library at school, reading Enemy and Melody Maker and stuff, and I saw that, and I put just Joe Tempest and Joey Tempest together. So no, it's mainly Joey, really, all around. But close family would say Joakim, I think. Yeah, not really. We're pretty relaxed. Having said that, some gigs are not so relaxed. John and John, the string guys, usually sit and warm up their fingers for 45 or half an hour. Sometimes an hour if we haven't played for a few weeks. I'm usually walking around winding people up, you know, trying to get them, joke with them like, are you really going to wear that? Things like that. That worked wonders. Just a few minutes before you go on stage on an important TV or important big show, you turn to your bandmate and say, you're going to look like that? Things like that really work well. So I try to just get people in the mood, and because I get a bit excited and I get a bit, you know, it's a bit nervous, positive energy, and I want to get everybody excited for the show. But just, you know, put your stuff on, and sometimes we listen to some music. You put Rival Sons, Pressure and Time on just before, just to get into that, that rock and roll groove, you know, and feel it. I do that a lot. The other guys don't listen to so much music before, but I do. I want to put on some great music, maybe Van Halen or something. Something that kicks and moves you and gets you into the spirit. So that helps me as well. Yeah, it was an interesting period doing those three solo albums. I was sort of missing the band more and more as I was doing them. but I don't know. If there's time, I might do some more, but there's nothing on the horizon because Europe takes up all my time and we have a lot of fun at the moment. We're getting you know, good reactions from our albums and good reviews, and we're ready to tour again. We're going to go, obviously, back in the UK next year, 2014, with Foreigner, and there's already some Spanish dates scheduled, and we have festivals coming up, and so we'll be touring 2014 as well as recording our next album, the 10th studio album. We don't know when exactly we're going to release it. Hopefully, end of next year, and that would be great if that plan works. So we'll be writing this winter and touring next year and recording. You know, it's our life. We're just having fun at the moment, you know. Live at Sweden Rock. I mean, I'm not just plugging that DVD. It was we played 28 songs. We had two of our biggest heroes on stage with us, Scott Gorman, Michael Schenker. We played at home in our home country in front of 30,000 people. We had 14 cameras there. We recorded the most important DVD of our career. I mean, it just sums up everything. We played songs that we hadn't played, like Prisoners in Paradise. John and us, we never played it together. So we really did a special thing there. And the feeling and the emotion was really strong on that gig when we played Seven Doors, maybe our first sort of hit song and stuff. You start looking around, the same guys around you. And it was really emotional as well. And afterwards, I remember saying to Neil Warnock from the agency group, our agent here in the, I said, it went well. We're so lucky because things could have gone wrong, but it was a lovely show. And it was definitely one of the highlights. It's been a few. I remember Milton Keynes, I think it was 89, played with Bon Jovi, Skid Row, and in front of 60,000 people. That was a fun gig to do. There's been other things. Earlier this year, we toured with Def Leppard and Whitesnake in Spain, and to play with those two bands and hang out and just... I also got to join David Coverdale on stage in Still of the Night for the second time. It's magic, you know, and there's been so much. This year has been quite an interesting year, actually. Sweden Rock, touring with Def Leppard and Whitesnake. Me and John Norum were doing a thing in Vegas, a fundraiser with Kiss and Alice Cooper and a lot of other acts. It's been a strange and magic and fun year, and hopefully the future in 2014 will be even better. Thanks, guys, for all your questions. That was fun. I hope the answers were okay. Don't forget to join me. I'll be back here at Planet Rock on New Year's Eve with Paul Anthony. We have a show we call The Final Countdown, and playing some of our favorite tracks and some stories too, of course, you know. So I'll see you then, New Year's Eve from 10 o'clock, The Final Countdown Show. Me and Paul Anthony just going to have a blast.